National Criminal Justice Reference Center, NCJRS, is an excellent place for students to find research on all types of subjects relating to the justice system. So, if you're conducting research on anything from drug abuse to repeat offenders, this database can provide great resources for you. However, sometimes it can be a bit confusing when you approach a new database. That's why I'm here to tell you a little bit about how to find materials on the NCJRS. When you come to the homepage, you'll be greeted with several ways to find information. One easy way to browse topics and find information is by clicking the A to Z topic list located on the left-hand side of the screen. Let's say you want to find information about juvenile offenders. You would navigate to the J's to see which terms NCJRS uses to identify this topic. You can see that it tells us that we need to refer to juvenile justice, juvenile delinquency, to find information about juvenile offenders. In this case, we can just click on the provided link for the subject. This will bring you to the Juvenile Justice, Juvenile Delinquency topic page. Here you can see a list of questions and answers, publications, and related links. Clicking on the More link under any of these categories will bring up the entire list of that particular area. For example, clicking on More Publications will bring up a much larger list of publications available on this topic. Also note that there is a keyword box at the top of the page that allows you to search within that category. If you want to know about recidivism rates of juvenile offenders, you can type in recidivism, and it will narrow your search to include only those items pertinent to your topic. Let's talk for a minute about the publication results. Although there are many results in NCJRS that are available in full text, some are not. Full text means that the entire article is available to you with just a click of the link. It may be on a web page or attached as a PDF for you to download. An abstract is a short summary of the full article, written either by the author, publisher, or reviewer. When you see an article listed in NCJRS that is abstract, that means that you can see the abstract to decide if you are interested in the full article. But NCJRS does not have the permission or capability to provide that entire article. If you find an abstract-only citation and you wish to read the entire article, contact a Harrison librarian as it may be available through interlibrary loan. All of the articles and reports that you find through the A to Z topic list will be available in full text, so that is an excellent option for starting your research. But let's say that you want to use the cite search box located in the upper right-hand corner of the NCJRS webpage. Entering a simple search will bring back mixed results, both full text and abstract-only. If you type in juvenile offenders, recidivism, you'll see that NCJRS has broken the results into full text and abstract only. You can tell by the fact that there is no PDF or HTML link that the abstracts only documents are not available in full text. If you wanted to conduct a free text search of NCJRS, the best option is to click on the advanced search link next to the search box in the upper right hand corner. You can simply uncheck the boxes for the items you don't want to show up in your search results. For example, if you uncheck the boxes for spotlights, publications with abstract only, related links, and justice events, your search will only return results that are full text publications, federal justice websites, or question and answers. Next, you choose what type of search you want to conduct. If you want all of the words in your search to be included in the results, any of the words, or if you want to search for the entered word as a phrase, using all is similar to using the Boolean operator AND. This will bring back fewer results that contain every word in your search string. Using any is similar to using or. It will bring back more results because it will treat each word individually. It would bring back items with the word juvenile, items with just the word offenders, and items on recidivism. Using a phrase is like putting a quote around your search string. It will only bring back items that have that exact wording. If we type in juvenile offender recidivism and use the all button, you can see that we get a little over 170 articles in the full text, as well as hundreds of results from federal websites. However, if we search for all those keywords as a phrase, we get zero results. I think this is because we used the word offender and not offenders. So if we go back to our search and use offenders,
we get
some results that are less than the number when we search for all words, but still very targeted to our search. If you're ever unsure of whether or not a word should be plural, you can always use a wildcard, asterisk, to signal that you want the items containing the first part of your search, regardless of the ending. For example, typing offender asterisk will bring back results with both offender and offenders in the text. If you just typed OFFEN asterisk, it could bring back offenders, offenses, offending. Any type of ending that comes after the OFFEN would be considered as a hit. That pretty much sums up the best ways for you to find information within the NCJRS. Feel free to explore the other types of information available as well. Remember, if you come across an item that is not in the full text, we may still be able to get it for you through interlibrary loan, so don't be afraid to contact a librarian for assistance at harrison.librarian@harrison.edu. Happy searching!